We're turning now to Hawke's Bay and the revelation about the inadequately sterilised surgical equipment. And Sheila Thomas, the president of the Sterile Sciences Association, who works at Hutt Valley DHB, says it's one of the worst things that can happen in a hospital. She and her colleagues are shocked it's happened. Mrs Thomas explains to our producer Bridget Berg that the sterilisation process in hospitals is complex in order to prevent the spread of infection.
Surgical instruments, when used on a patient, come back to our department, and they are obviously covered. They've been inside a human body and contain blood and tissue from a person. Now, obviously, we cannot just wash that instrument and use it for the next patient. What we have to do is to ensure that that blood and tissue has been thoroughly removed. If these instruments sit for more than half an hour, they form a barrier or biofilm in which bacteria grow. And if we leave it too long, we can't get that bacteria thoroughly off. So it's really important to thoroughly clean these instruments. And we do that by a mixture of manual cleaning and automated cleaning. In the automated cleaning, the instruments are washed and rinsed using specific detergents. Some are alkaline-based, some are acid-based. These detergents remove the bacteria, they remove the tissue and anything else that's left on the instruments. And then we thermally disinfect these instruments. So we know they are clean. They're cleaner than clean. The thing we have a saying is that you cannot sterilise anything unless it is clean, because you can take a dirty instrument or an instrument which still has a bit of tissue on it and you can put it in a steriliser, but you've still got tissue on it. It may be sterilised tissue, but that tissue or that bacteria can go into the next patient and cause an infection or a reaction. So it's vitally important that the cleaning process is undertaken first, and that is done really well before you put it in the steriliser.
Are there three steps to that sterilisation process?
Yes. The first is the pre-cleaning at the point of use. So I'd say four steps. Pre-cleaning at the point of use. So that's where, when it's just been used on the patient and they're still in theatre, they wipe the instruments down before they send them back to the sterilisation department. They're pre-cleaned again. They may be soaked in an enzymatic detergent to get off bone and tissue, and then they're loaded into our washers, which are, you know, very expensive pieces of equipment, and they're thoroughly washed and disinfected. The next step of the process is called inspection and packing. So what we do is the instruments come out of the washers. They're very, very clean. And each instrument is inspected. It's inspected to make sure it functions correctly, and it's inspected to ensure that there's no foreign material, you know, dirt, tissue, etc., left on that instrument. It's then either packed in a specific sterilising crate, which is a sealable lid, or it's put into a special sterilisation basket and wrapped in a sterilisation wrap, which is then ready to go into the autoclave or the steriliser, as we call it, and that's where it goes through the process of sterilisation at 134 degrees centigrade for 4 minutes.
Sheila, without prejudging the outcome of an independent investigation that will be no doubt undertaken at Hawke's Bay DHB to determine exactly how that process was compromised,
yeah,
does it happen often inside a hospital environment where that process is in fact flawed?
I would like to say that, I can say for mine, and I think they've got the same ones at Hawke's Bay, your autoclaves give an automated printout. Now, part of your process every day is when your autoclave is finished and that printout, you as a technician or the technicians need to look at that printout. They need to understand that printout and they need to understand that the autoclave has gone through the processes that it should have gone through. That is that it's pulled a vacuum, it's injected steam, it's done this repeatedly, it's reached its 134 degrees, it's maintained that for 4 minutes constantly. And then at the end of it, it will say cycle finished or cycle aborted or whatever. And that technician is bound to read that and sign. Yes, the cycle has passed. No, the cycle has failed.
You're telling me there are sufficient checks and balances, redundancy, resilience built into the process.
Yes, yes, definitely. These are the things that we have to do. We also run, I know Hawke's Bay is the same as where I work here in Lower Hutt. They run a tracking system. Now, part of the standards is that we have to be able to track and trace our instruments. So that means from the patient into the decontamination, it's tracked.
How can it be then, Sheila, that it took a nurse to notice something was awry?
I do not know. I mean, it could be that it was work pressure. It could have been the time of the day. I don't know. But as a manager, I would be asking the question, why didn't you follow process and why didn't you check what you were doing?
What are you hearing from your peers and colleagues? What's the chat?
From my peers and colleagues around the country, they're absolutely gobsmacked that it's happened. They're absolutely, you know, they're shocked. And I think they're shocked for the technician and for the manager of the CSSD that they're having to deal with this and that, you know, this has happened. Because if it does happen, it doesn't always come to the public attention. I think it's maybe hidden, but this is the first time it's really come out to the public attention. So we're all shocked that this has happened, and we really feel for the Hawke's Bay in this instance.
Are you telling me that you know of occasions where the process of sterilising surgical instruments or other hospital goods and supplies has been breached and not been reported?
I can't comment on that because I cannot confirm it because I don't have concrete evidence.
Is this one of the worst things that could happen at a hospital?
I believe it is. Well, from my perspective, it is, yes.